Was on there.
Right, so you know what's in the plastic, so.
So you know what's in the plastic.
Pull in or not?
Right. And I guess you get right down to it, they could then still have a placard on the Lake Laura sign and the perimeter sign that says, hey, there's a Dollar General back here somewhere, you just gotta go find it.
Right, and then it's gonna say Dollar General on the building, and they can put that on the building.
You know, once you drive up in there, like you say, yeah, it's gonna say big yellow letters, Dollar General.
If it doesn't say out by the street what's in there, I'm not even gonna drive in, cause I'm not inclined to, like, search for things. I wanna know what they are.
Well, this sign, if I understand correctly, would not preclude a placard on the big sign out front.
Right.
If that's where you're going with it.
So they can have both?
Yes.
Tracy, will this sign for this new business, the Dollar Tree or whatever, will it be similar to the ones of the Dairy Queen? That's a monument sign, isn't it?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
And it will be, that's a 7-foot sign?
Yes, ma'am.
So it will look very much like that?
I wouldn't, let me take that back, I wouldn't guarantee that the Dairy Queen sign is 7 feet. I stood next to it, I'm 5'2", it seemed awfully tall. And I'll clarify with the fact that I'm awfully short. I did not go back and double check the permit. The sign in that corridor can be no taller than 18 feet. The DQ sign is not 18 feet in that. It's what I would call monument sign, it's probably 3 or 4 feet tall in the present. So I would venture to guess, very similar in height, very similar in nature to the Dollar Tree proposal.
Reasonable aesthetically.
A question, what do you classify as a directional sign?
Drive-through.
Anything that shows us drive-through over here on this side of the building, is that considered a directional sign?
We have specific that, and we have specific parameters in the only yards of what a directional sign can be. No taller than 2.5 feet, no larger than either 2.5 or 3 square feet in copying area.
Right.
So short, ATA this way, drive-through that way, that kind of thing.
So you're, just clarifying, your recommendation here, item number 3, says you recommend no directional signs allowed either. So somebody wants to put a Walgreens with a drive-through on it or something back there, or something else, they can't have any directional signs on their site to show.
Per staff recommendation, yes, sir, but you have the option, the alternative to.
And it's good or?
Tracy, can you subdivide a parcel with its only access being a private drive?
I'm not as involved as me, I should be in the planning process, that I couldn't.
Any other questions, any other discussions? Is there anyone here in support of this application?
Hi, I'm Sarah Barlow, an engineer with LEA, and I'm here representing the client. My address is 39998 Interperimeter Road, and I'm available for any questions you may have.
Is the developer planning on selling the parcels?
I'm not sure at this time. The previous ones have been sold, though, as you can see, the what was shown before.
We haven't had.
Any other questions?
Yeah, I've got a question. Do you know if you can subdivide a parcel with access being limited to private drive?
I actually don't know the answer to that question. I'm not involved in that process.
And what other plans are in the works in regards to this development? Do you only have a proposal for just this one store and parking area right now?
Yes.
And then the rest is just a blank slate.
Correct. We have conceptual plans, but the one that's drawn right now is the only one that's actually gone any further than just conceptual parcel layout.
Any other questions? Thank you very much. Is anyone else here in support of this request? Is there anyone here that has questions about what is being requested or is in opposition to what is being requested? Was there any contact to the office, Tracy?
Yes, and from the property assessor's office of all people. They were apparently the outdoors and don't park saw the sign and wanted to know what variance would be hired. And that was the only contact I had.
And they had no objection or approval or nothing? They just wanted to know.
They couldn't raise the sign and they wanted to know.
Talking that dog.
So that's too small.
Okay, any other questions, discussion? Can I get a motion on this request?
I make a motion to approve the variance request with the staff recommendations on this.
Have motion to accept with the recommendations as suggested from staff. Do I have a second? Second, Nancy. All in favor, please raise a hand. Thank you very much. For the record, Tracy, I guess you need to note that we had a member that had to leave, but I didn't know that. I looked around and called you a dog. Okay, next case we'll call city case application 2017-06, Axis Infrastructure 4109 Beaver Road.
Your next city case is from Axis Infrastructure. You're going to recognize this site better as the McDonald's slash Flash Foods on the corner of Bemis and Skipper Bridge Road. It's about an acre and a half and contains a fast food restaurant and a convenience store. McDonald's is currently under some renovations. They submitted plans for some interior renovations and for some exterior adjustments like parking renovations, parking restriping, things of that nature. As a part of their renovations, they submitted a sign application. Some of the wall signs, some of it being board and pre-sold. The wall signs were within reason. I could approve those. The pre-sale and the mini boards were a little bit bigger than what I've been approved. They currently have two mini boards, about 50 square foot each, for a total of 100 square feet total. They are proposing two pre-sale boards and two mini boards. The LDR has a cap of 48 square feet. You can configure that 48 square feet however you would like. One big mini board, two smaller mini boards. However, as long as you're at that 48 square foot cap or below, they are proposing 53.13 square feet. Now, an administrative variance is a possibility for 10% over. However, that 10% over takes them to 52.8 square feet, which is just below the 53.13 square feet that they're proposing, which they are just too big for, and just slightly too big for the administrative variance group. We did review it, unfortunately found no hardship, and recommend the denial of the request. Any questions?
No, I don't guess. Anybody have any questions? Yes, Nancy, go ahead.
First of all, what is the pre-sale board? I run out there. Is that the little side board? I saw the menu board,
right,
with the little top.
Currently, they don't have a pre-sale board. It's the board that you look at before you get to the mini board. Generally, they're a little bit smaller, about half the size.
Okay.
And you're waiting in the line,
yeah,
so you can see what's available.
Right.
Okay, the other question I've got, when they are doing this remodeling and they're talking to the sign people,
mm-hmm,
don't they give them these requirements? I mean, when you're designing a sign, we're talking about very little difference here.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't look like it's going to make or break as long as the sign people are in the planning,
mm-hmm,
aspect of their sign.
Mm-hmm.
Do they not give them these specifications?
Sometimes yes, sometimes no.
entire longevity, usually they come in and they say, this is our standard site that they had engineered through their corporate offices. We saw it with Holiday Inn, we saw it with Hampton Inn, we saw it with Howard. Any of them, they come in and they say, this is our standard site. And somebody in corporate commissioned somebody outside Lowndes County to do it, and they come in and say, these are the signs we're going to use. The local sign company merely sets them up. And so in most cases that I've been associated with, they come in and the sign company says, well, but you can't do that. And they say, okay, well, that's for variance.
Sorry, I thought you had a question.
So just so I understand, we're talking about a variance here on menu signs and pre-sale signs, and it's 5.13 square feet?
Correct.
And what's not allowed by administrative variance and brings a variance to us is less than 1 square foot?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right.
You getting mail on you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, any other questions, any other discussions? Thank you very much. Is the applicant here or anyone representing the applicant, please come to the lectern and tell us what you're going to do and why we ought to grant it.
Teresa Curry, 1111 Cambridge Square, Alpharetta, Georgia. What we currently have now are two large menu boards. They're each 50 square feet, which on their own is more than what you allow today. McDonald's is getting away from those large menu boards. They find the customers don't even read them. They usually know what they want. So they're going with much smaller menu boards. They're digital. They're going to have the breakfast menu during breakfast hours, and then the lunch dinner menu. So they're just a lot smaller. And then we have the pre-sale boards for the specials, because they're always running whatever, buy two for get one free. So we're actually reducing the 100 square feet that we have today to the 53.2 square feet that we're requesting. We would be allowed the two menu boards and the one pre-sale board, so we're really asking for the variance to install a second pre-sale board because we have two drive-through lanes. Yeah, that's about it.
Any questions, any discussions?
And the sign manufacturer only makes one size. You know, you can't call them up and say, hey, you just shrink it down a couple inches. So.
Okay, thank you very much. Is anyone else here in support of this application? Is anyone here in opposition or have questions about what's being requested? Ladies and gentlemen, do you have any further discussions? Any questions? Can we entertain a motion on this application? Can I entertain?
I make a motion that we approve the application.
That's presented.
That's presented.
Any conditions?
No conditions.
Have a motion on the floor to grant the request as presented. Any second?
Second.
Second, Mr. Alvarado. All in favor? Any discussion, anything? All in favor, raise your hand. All opposed? Okay, we got 4-1. Thank you very much.
Thank
you.
Good
luck
with
it.
Welcome to
that Tyson.
Okay, the last case for time is application 2017-07, by Lutheran Church, 500 Patriot Road. Ms. Tracy, it is your show again.
Yes, this is for the variance from the Massage Lutheran Church. I was running 3 for 3 for sign variances this month. They are asking for variance for a digital LED board to go with as a part of the freestanding sign. Their property is currently zoned R10, just a shooting less than 2 acres. It is on the corner of Bay Tree McClellan. They are It's a church. They currently have a freestanding sign that is a static panel up top that consists of 15.6 square feet and a manual reader board. By manual reader board, I mean you take the letters down and put the letters up. Instead of programming it from a laptop, cell phone, things of that nature, that you can do digitally, that is about 21.84 square feet. So the sign is a little over 37 square feet. They are asking to replace that bottom panel with an LED panel, the same size, same shape. That is allowed only in CC and CH districts, in other words, commercial zoning districts, not R10 that the particular church is zoned currently. They had two options, A, rezoning, which they weren't eligible from a character area standpoint, or B, from a variance standpoint, they could ask for a variance. Matt recommended the variance route, so they chose to apply for the variance. We reviewed the case, had some concerns about this section of bakery being more residential. Yes, there is a digital message board down the street, President Oak Street, that is on property owned by VSU. VSU is exempt from the sign regulations. There are two additional LED boards that are closer to Bakery's intersection with Jerry Jones and Melody Lane, both on CC community commercial properties. So they are both commercially zoned properties, which this property is zoned residential. Unfortunately, staff did not find a hardship and they recommended no.
Any questions, any discussions?
Just to clarify, if they were CC, they could have it by right.
Yes, ma'am.
Any other questions or discussion?
And why did Matt recommend a variance as opposed to rezoning?
Because he felt like that was the best route that rezoning for us. Rezoning purely for a sign was the greater thing.
Even though he leaned toward not toward denying this.
Yes, sir.
That sounds like a lose-win situation.
Any other questions? Hold on 1 second.
I got a quick question. Is it unusual for a church to be in R10 zoning? It just seems like there's inappropriate zoning.
Yeah, there are churches in residential districts.
Church been there since 1950. I've been there since 1962.
Now what happens is these churches were more than likely built either prior to zoning or prior to churches being a CDP in a residential district. Under today's circumstances, churches in most residential districts need what they call a conditional use permit, or a CUP, to make sure that it is appropriate for a church of a particular size to be located in a particular area. But churches before that are in residential districts that follow.
And where this falls, correct me if I'm wrong, but this is a legal non-conforming use because it's predated the zone.
Yes, sir.
Lots of them all over the town.
Do you have any idea how many digital signs there are at churches? How many of them have been changed now?
I do not.
Okay, any other questions, discussions for Tracy? Okay. If there's anybody, either the applicant or someone representing the applicant, now is your chance to come talk to us.
I'm Catherine Lane. I represent the Side Lutheran Church, 500 Bay Tree Road. We're asking for this variance to move forward with our sign. We don't want our sign any larger than what it is there, where we have to change the lettering to bring us up to date. I know we're zoned residential, but in that Bay Tree corridor where we're at, it's all businesses. You know, if you pass BSU, and each house is now a business. on Bay Tree. If you go across the street on McLeod, Bay Tree and McLeod, it is a real estate company. The temple is across the street from us, you know. I don't know what they're zoning, but, you know, I don't understand the zoning other than it was a long time ago, you know. All we're asking for is to be able to put an insert in there to bring us up to where it is a little bit easier to change the sign on a regular basis.
Yes, ma'am. And part of that, in order to try to be as uniform as possible for everybody all over the place, that's why they try to put the rules and regulations and designations for the different classifications.
Mm-hmm.
And that's also why the variance process is in there, so that people such as the church can ask for a variance. It is not specifically allowed, it is not specifically denied, but you have to ask for the variance. And that's why we have to go through this process.
Yeah, we're just asking to come up into the 21st century instead of staying in the 19th century.
Yes, ma'am. Any questions, any comments, anything for?
Please don't ask me any questions.
Is anyone else who would like to give any?
I would.
Okay.
My name is Rhonda Urisatano, and I live at 150 Mockingbird Crossing in Payhiller, Georgia. And it's also a hardship. It's an older sign, and in order to change it, there's a little key here. You have to unlock it. You have to pull that glass slab up. It comes up. It's an older sign. One part of it will hang, the other one doesn't. And then to get it down, then you've got to make sure it doesn't come down on you. I've changed the sign many times. I was church secretary for a while. And then when you want to put it down, after you change the sign manually and everything, it's a little time to set it in, bugs out there, and there's just spiders. But then it sticks, and you have to jimmy with it. I have to pinch my thing. It's a little bit of a hardship that way because it is such an older sign. Patty now has that pump, and she's out there playing with it. So there are times we would like to change the sign a little bit more, something a little catchier. Just signs will change. And ours is like, oh, please don't. You know, it's because it can be hazardous. You know, yes, it could be. It's going to be a time of a week because it's showing definite signs of that now. It's the inconvenience is yes. The confirmation, it's old, it needs replaced, it's interactive, might as well, you know, get something more.
So the game plan is to
give one second.
Go ahead and ask your question.
This fancy new sign, will we be able to turn down how bright it is in the evening? So it's like when people are sleeping in the neighborhood behind you, won't be beaming bright giant light and turn it on.
If it's visual, you can turn that off during the time. I'm not sure
about that part.
You can program it to come on and off at times.
Okay, so at this point, they are actually talking about removing that sign in its entirety and replacing it.
No. Just that part right there. That's all we want to do.
You want to take that part out?
We already have electricity there, okay?
Okay.
Remove that part on both sides and make it electronic on both sides. So the fat lady doesn't have to get out there in the weather and change it.
Okay. I understand. I just wanted it to be in the record that this was a modification or redesign, not a complete sign.
That's right. We don't want to change the Messiah Lutheran Church at the top or anything.
Just one in the minutes correct.
Okay.
Is there anyone else here in support that would like to say anything? Is there anyone here in opposition to this request? Was there any contact through your office, Tracy? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you have it?
I'm ready to go.
You're ready to go. Well, I have to ask a question. Is there any more discussion or questions? Now you may go.
I make a motion that we approve the request, citing Mike Hill.
I caught that.
I didn't hear.
Appreciate that. I have a motion on the floor from Gretchen to grant as requested.
Yes.
Do I have a second?
Second.
I have a second, Mr. Alvarado. All in favor, raise your hand. Unanimous, the resolution.
Thank you, thank you.
Y'all have the patience of Joe.
Well, I hope you sleep better in short.
I think I'm a good sign to get the voting.
See, this is just the cause.
One day, I had a bad church, son.
No.
I got one day, I heard. And I was like, second coming is going to be hard.
Okay, we still got business.
No more votes.
Okay, we have minutes from November. My computer was giving me fits for the last 5 days. I don't.
Thank you.
Anybody got any changes, modifications, deletions? I get a motion to accept. Motion Nancy to accept, Gretchen the second. All in favor, raise your hand, we'd love to win it. We have election of chairman and vice chairman. We had nominations last month, it was time to vote. All in favor of retaining everybody, vote no. All in favor of new people, vote yes. I'm just seeing if anybody's waiting around here.
Do you not want to be the chairman?
I will agree to serve. That's not a problem. There's not a question of do I want to. Okay, have a motion, or I'm sorry, we need a motion to adopt or elect chairman and vice chairman as presented in November.
I'll make such a motion.
Have a motion, do I have a second? That was awful hesitant, Nancy.
No, I did it first, and you
jumped. Well, I was looking the other way, and I saw it.
You were.
Okay, we have a motion, we have a second. All in favor, raise a hand. Thank you very much, I guess. Any opposition? Adoption of the 2018 calendar. We talked about that last month. It is here for your records. This is subject to change as things may happen, but I need to adopt this if you have no problem.
Yes.
Have a motion from somebody?
Second.
I have a motion, Gretchen. Second, Mr. Alvarado. I'm sorry, I didn't get far enough now.
I was just voting.
Okay. All in favor, raise your hand. Discussion item, holiday gathering.
Yes, sir. We've been gathering, Tracy and I, been gathering names. So far, there's nine. Got me down for two. Matt Hall, two. Victoria, two. Nathan, one. And Matt Martin, two.
We're two.
We're two. So far, we're at 11.
I'm 10.
Oh, you're going up?
Yes. Chairman.
Put me down to two.
So it's rolling. Tracy? Can't.
Deborah?
Two. And then John. Haven't heard from John. So it looks like everybody's coming. I've gotten embarrassing pasta salad, jalapeno, deviled eggs, meatballs, fresh apple cake.
I'm bringing gelatinous, congealed salad.
You can't be on that bitch. And then, so it's wide open.
Please tell us what else you need. Be glad to wait.
It's like free dessert.
And I'm going to do some dessert.
You want to do that?
Okay.
No, I'm going to do what? Some. Somebody can steal them. I've got some small sandwich.
Everything's pound cake. So, meat maybe? Yeah. Some
sure.
Meat. Make some veggies.
Okay.
It'll work, Kenny.
It'll work out? Or did they call?
I see a vegetable plate.
A vegetable plate. Two?
Okay.
Two.
Two.
Okay.
So this Sunday at 6 o'clock.
Okay.
This Sunday at 6 o'clock.
Sorry.
Sorry.